this GIMP workshop, we are going to make a nice photo collage. If you want to use the same images as in the video, you can find the download link in the video description. We will start by going to File, Open, and open the image that we want to use as our background. Click the icon in the top right corner to maximize the image in the window. Our background image is 1920 by 1280 pixels. When you use a bigger or smaller image, you might want to change the line width when we stroke the selection later on in the video. Click on the foreground background color to make the color palette visible. Fill in the HTML notation F, C, 8, C, B, 0. Then hit Enter to see the color in the current old preview pane. Click OK. Now we hit Ctrl A to select this image. Then we go to Edit in the menu bar and hit Stroke Selection. Make the line width 50 and click Stroke, which gives us a nice pink border. Hit Ctrl Shift A to select none. Go to File, Open as Layers, and open our second photo. Now press Shift C to activate the Crop tool. Here we check the Current Layer Only option. Go ahead and crop this image. By click and drag the handles and or the corners, we can change the cutout. By click and drag inside the cutout, we can move the selected area. Then hit Enter or click in one of the corners to apply. Press Shift T to activate the Scale tool. Make the layer invisible by clicking the eyeball. Click on the chain icon to lock the proportions when we scale the image. Now scale the image. By click and drag in the center circle, we can move the image to its proper position. Then we hit Scale and make the layer visible again. Now press Ctrl A to select this image. Go to Edit and hit Stroke Selection. Change the line width to 25 and hit Stroke. Now we hit Ctrl Shift A to deselect our image. Go to Filters in the menu bar, click on Light and Shadow, and then on Drop Shadow. Make the X and the Y offset both 7. Reduce the opacity to 40. Then click OK. Right-click on the image layer and hit Merge Down, so the image layer and the drop shadow layer become one layer. Time now for our third image. Go to File, Open as Layers, and open the next image. This image is bigger than our canvas, so we have to make some changes. Click Image and then Fit Canvas to Layers. Now we hit Ctrl Shift J to fit the image in the window. Press Shift C to activate the Crop tool. And crop the image. The option Current Layer Only is still active. Then hit Shift T to make the Scale tool active. Here the chain is still locked. Make its layer invisible again. Then we can scale and reposition this image. Then click Scale and make the layer visible. Press Ctrl A to select the image. Go to Edit and click Stroke Selection. Now we can just click on the Stroke button. Then we press Ctrl Shift A to select none. Then press Ctrl F to repeat the drop shadow. Right click on the image layer and hit Merge Down. We're going to repeat this process with the next photo. Go ahead and click File, Open as Layers, and open our fourth image. Press Shift C and crop the image. press Shift T and make the layer invisible. Now scale and reposition the image. Make the layer visible again. Press Ctrl A to select it. Go to Edit and hit Stroke Selection. Click Stroke. Press Ctrl Shift A to deselect. And press Ctrl F to repeat the drop shadow. Right click on the image layer and hit Merge Down. And that's number 4. In this way we can add as many photos to our collage as we like. For the sake of the tutorial, we will go fast forward now. Now we select the middle layer. Then we hit Shift R to activate the Rotate tool and rotate this image. Go ahead, select the second layer from the top. Then we hit Shift R to activate the Rotate tool and rotate this one too. In case we want to move one or more of the photos to change our composition, we click on its layer to make it active. Then we hit the M key on our keyboard to make the Move tool active. Check the option Move the active layer. And then we can click and drag that image. We can also move an image up or down in the layer stack. Select the layer and replace it with the green arrows at the bottom of the layers panel. In this way, we can place it above or below another image in our collage. All done? Click Image and hit Flatten Image. Then back to Image and now hit Auto Crop Image. Hit Ctrl Shift J to maximize the image in the window. And there we have it, a nice photo collage. I hope you enjoyed this workshop. If so, please like, subscribe, and leave a nice comment to support my channel. Thanks very much for watching.